Hey guys, welcome back to the Style and Beauty Doctor on YouTube, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about six things that are causing your adult acne. Now, adult acne is annoying enough on its own, but when you have like no idea what is causing you to break out, it can be even more frustrating. So I'm going to give you six things that can be causing your adult acne, so keep watching. As always with my list, these are not in any particular order. It's just that, you know, numbering things helps the flow of the video. So number one, hormones. Now hormones for some people can be one of the biggest causes of adult acne. So what's actually happening in our bodies as we age, you know, you get through your 20s, your 30s, your 40s, and so on. The hormone levels in the body tend to change. On average, now of course everyone is different, but on average, your estrogen levels are going down and that testosterone is kind of, you know, ticking up. And basically what that causes, you know, aside from a number of things, is that it can cause the skin to be like, yo, what's going on here? And it's just like, boop. So how do you treat it? So there are a number of over-the-counter products that you can use to treat adult acne. Now what you want to do is keep in mind that adult acne and the acne you get as a teenager are caused by two different things, and the treatments are going to be a little different. So for instance, as a teenager, typically your acne is caused by an overproduction of sebum, so a lot of the acne treatments are going to have a higher percentage of an active ingredient. As we get older, our skin tends to dry. So those high dosage, like, you know, high percentage benzoyl peroxide or the high percentage salicylic acid, that can be very drying on adult skin. So I typically go for low dosage. If I'm using something that's gonna be, you know, put on my face, like as a all over everyday kind of prevention of acne, I usually like to look for something that's like 0.5% to 1% salicylic acid. So for what I use for adult acne, I have a post below that talks about what I did when I had a really bad bout of adult acne and what I used to treat it. So make sure you check that out. So you definitely don't want to go it alone, despite what the internet may make you think. You may want to make sure that you're showing up for your regular visits with your primary care doctor, as well as your GYN, because, you know, a change in hormones can also signify other things that you may want to get checked out. So definitely make sure that you are checking in with a doctor. For very progressive or severe adult acne, being under the care of a dermatologist can be extremely helpful because they can offer you treatments that go beyond what you can get over the counter. So see a doctor. So number two, not properly cleansing. Not properly cleansing can lead you down a road of many, many things with your skin. But when you're not properly cleansing, and I mean, you know, some folks like to say, oh, I don't wear makeup, so I'm good. No, there are things such as free radicals, there's pollution, there's dirt and oil that can sit on the skin surface in addition to makeup that, you know, you want to make sure that you're cleansing properly. Now, for more information on properly cleansing, I talk about double cleansing. I talk about deep cleansing and how often you might want to do it, and exfoliation. There is going to be a blog post linked in the description box for you to check out all that information, because like these like half-assed, like, you know, face washing, like that's not gonna cut it. So make sure you check out the description box for that post for more information on properly cleansing your skin. Because if you're not properly cleansing your skin, you can be leading, you know, an environment where your pores are constantly getting clogged, and clogged pores can lead to acne. So number three, dirty pillowcases and dirty head wraps. And I'm gonna add dirty wig as well, because I think out of all the hairstyles, that most of my hairstyles are usually off of my face, because, you know, hair products and hair in my face is typically not my thing, because one, I'm always like, oh, get this hair out my face. And then two, like if there's like a lot of product buildup in the hair, I don't want that on my face, because my skin can, you know, be a little sensitive to some of the hair care products. But, you know, you want to make sure your environment is clean. So dirty pillows especially, make sure you're changing your pillowcases often. You want to try to sleep on either a satin or silk pillowcase, because that helps to keep the skin smooth. It's a nice environment. You know, cotton pillowcases sometimes can be a little rough on the skin. So, you know, try to, you know, be gentle on your skin, be soothing. Dirty head wraps, same thing, because a lot of times, you know, like if you're laying your edges and you're putting this wrap on, after you've done your makeup and then you have makeup on it and then you wash your face, but then you put the dirty head wrap on top of it. It's, you know, it's counterproductive. So make sure that, you know, and these head wraps don't cost that much. Like, you can get, you know, satin ones at the beauty supply store or for like, what, $2, $3, what have you. You know, get a bunch of them so you don't have to keep wearing the same one over and over. And also with your hair products, you know, be cognizant that that's like touching your face and being in your face very often. So, you know, switch things up. Maybe, you know, do some more hairstyles that are away from the face. Maybe vary the wigs that you're wearing so that you're not constantly having, you know, things that can cause acne all around your face. All right, so number four was, you know, your hair care products, and I kind of already touched on that because I, you know, went a little bit side myself with it. But number four, we'll say it again. Number four, your hair routine, gels, the glues that you're using to glue your wigs down. I personally don't think that I would ever use hair glue or hairspray or whatever it is to hold my wigs down, just because my skin seems to already not like hair care products anywhere near it. When I gel my hair down, sometimes I might, you know, have Gabby give me a little baby hair action or whatever, but I usually don't keep those hairstyles in long because I kind of feel like, you know, the hair product residue sits on my skin, you know, just leaves an environment for my skin to break out more. So be very cognizant with your hair care products. Even sometimes, like if you're washing your hair, there may be something in your shampoo or your conditioner that your skin doesn't like. So even though you're washing your hair, as you're rinsing it out, it might be going down on your face. So you want to be more cognizant of that. Maybe, you know, kind of try to keep your head back when you're rinsing your hair out to, you know, prevent so much product from getting on your face. So number four, essentially being very cognizant and being very careful about, you know, the type of hair products and the hair and all that stuff that's going to be in your face. Okay, so number five, your cell phone. Now, a lot of us, because, you know, there's the AirPods and the, the headphones that you can stick in. So a lot of people aren't necessarily on their phones like this as much anymore. But you're also like typing, we're typing on our phones more often, and then we may not be cognizant of us, you know, touching our faces and, you know, what other surfaces we're touching and then touching our phone and then touching our faces. It's just like, So when it comes to your cell phone, you want to make sure that you're wiping your phone down regularly. You want to make sure you're washing your hands regularly. I live in New York City, and anytime I get on the train or even if I just like leave my apartment, I just kind of feel like, oh my God, the first thing I need to do after I get in the house is to wash my hands because like, ugh. And then like as soon after that, I'm like, I want to shower because I'm just like, ugh. So make sure that you're washing your hands often. And just be cognizant of what you touch and like touching your face because, you know, and not only that, like that can also lead to, you know, the flu and the common cold and, you know, other kinds of things. So watch what your hands are touching and how your hands are touching your face. So number six, your skincare routine is doing the utmost. So some people think like the more the merrier when it comes to skincare. There are certain skincare products that you should not be using often. Like for instance, a deep cleanser. So deep cleansers are good to use maybe like once or twice a week just to make sure that you're, you know, really giving your skin a good deep cleanse. Like if you're wearing makeup or, you know, just in general because there's a lot of pollutants and then dirt and oil and things like that. But if you're using a deep cleanser every day and if you're using it twice a day every day, that's something that could be stripping your skin and it can cause irritation, which can cause breakouts and other issues with your skin that you don't want. So while you're doing your skincare routine, not only is it important to be consistent, but also I know that we have grown to become a nation of where there are people that don't like to read and do things all fast and quick. But, you know, take your time, turn that product around, and read to make sure that you understand how often the product is intended for use. Because there are products that you should not use every day, and you could be doing the most and causing your skin to break out as a result. So I wanted to give an honorable mention here for diet. Now, the reason why diet's not like a definite on my list is because diet is such a thing that can vary from person to person. Not only that, but some of the information out there on certain foods that cause acne can be conflicting. So, you know, you want to read up. But if you notice that when you eat certain things, it doesn't, you know, work well for your body or your skin, you know, don't eat it. Now, me personally, I tend to avoid some dairy, and that's mostly because it hurts my stomach and that's not conducive to like my carefree lifestyle. You can't be carefree if you need to be, you know, on the porcelain throne every 5 minutes. But of course, these are conversations that you want to have with your doctor. But, you know, diet can be, for some people, a trigger for acne. Leave me a comment below. Did one of the things or one or more of the things that I listed causing your acne? Tell me all about it in the comments. Don't forget to check out the description box because there will be links to more information, especially the blog post that I mentioned about proper cleansing. Make sure you check that out. Also in the description box will be links to follow me on social, because when I'm not here on YouTube, I'm elsewhere on the internet, like Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, you know, Pinterest, you name it. Also make sure that you are subscribed to this channel because, you don't want to miss out. I feel like I give good information and I give good attitude when I'm giving the good information. So make sure you subscribe and turn on my notifications so that you know when a new video uploads. Thumbs up if you want to see more videos like this. And I will see you fine folks in my next video. Bye, guys.